همین داره هوا باز میشه.
The sky seems to be clearing a little bit, but the weather is very polluted. It is extremely polluted.
خیلی واقعا هوا آلوده است، عجیب. طرفای وقتی خوبی چون شد شما دو نفر رو چه عجب دیدیم ما سلام همان حالتون خوبی چلا سلام شد
سری پروپیل آمینی که رادیکالی تبدیل میشه
تایگر ثابت هست
که در انتها به اصطلاح این دوتا به اصطلاح گونه ای که به فرم رادیکالی در اومدن به هم برخورد میکنن و در نهایت یه که اینا هم نقش یعنی به جای اینکه تری پروپیلامین استفاده کنی از اون استفاده کنی
الکتروداشون دارن اصلاح میکنن و تست بزنن تا شالا ببینیم جوابش چجوری میشه.
از سال 82 افتخار شاگردی جناب آقای پروفسور گنجلی رو داشتم در دانشگاه تهران.
همه مراحل و همه به اصطلاح مراحل تحقیق، مراحلی که تا الان به اصطلاح گذروندیم مدیون شخصیت دکتر و خود دکتر گنجلی هستیم.
با اون نانو پارتیکلایی که غیر فعالن با هم میکس که میشن خوب. یه دفعه سینرژیک افکت های خیلی واضح و قشنگ تری مشخص میشه روشون تو الکترودا تو رفتارشون.
یه نگاه کردم اتفاقا دنبال یه ریویو که قدیما خودم نگاه میکردم زمانی که سر دانشجو بودیم اون ریویو رو الان گیر آوردم.
آقای دکتر گنجالی به عنوان مرد صنعت میشناختنش و کسی هستش که از صنعت وارد علم شد، یعنی علمی که بودن، یعنی وارد تحقیقات علمی و واقعا من خودم پدر علمی خودم میشناسم ایشونو.
روابطمون فراتر از روابط به اصطلاح استاد شاگرد هست و حضورش رو در خیلی از مواقع استفاده کردیم در پیشبرد به اصطلاح اهداف تحقیقاتی و حتی یه سری از مسائل شخصیمون ازش استفاده کردیم و کمک میگیریم.
مکانیزمش رو به طور واقعی در بیاری و وقت میتونیم خیلی کارهای قشنگ و جالب انشاءالله براش طراحی بکنیم و انجام بدیم با امید خدا.
According to my ID card, I was born on the 21st of April 1958 in Tehran. While I was a bachelor in Tehran University, I was really fond of chemistry. In high school, when I was in 11th grade, usually my teacher, Mr. Khosravi, God bless his soul, while entering the class would say, Ganjali, come to the blackboard and start teaching. And I would teach. At that time, I also studied and solved problems of the 12th grade's textbooks. I actually love chemistry. My mother desired very much that I'd become a physician, but I had really no interest in medicine. My grade at the college entrance exam was way more than sufficient to choose any study course, but I was keen on chemistry. I don't know really, but in high school, it was amazing how I loved chemistry, as well as theology. If I had to forget about chemistry, I would have definitely gone for theology. It is something that emerges by itself, but I don't know how.
خیلی لطفا خیلی شده از شما یاد گرفتیم.
For my MSc, I entered the industry, and for my PhD, I worked on electroplating design and acquiring the knowledge of brighteners and electroplating. At the time, those were foreign patents, and except for four companies in the world, no one else produced them. Their formulas were kept secret, and very high prices were paid for them. I was basically working to derive their theory. And when it came to defend my PhD thesis, some interesting thing happened. One of my friends, who was actually the head of the College of Chemistry, and had come from NASA, said that my defense was very good, but my claim about the lack of any theory for this job and for me to be the first individual ever to derive a theory for it was absolutely false. I said, if that's what you think, no problem. You don't have to grade my defense case right now. Leave it for a couple of months later and take whatever time you need to check on your allegations. 6 months from now, I will come back. If you happen to have found a pre-existing theory in the world, I would put my thesis aside and go for another subject. Otherwise, you would have to make up somehow. He insisted, no, there must be a theory written on this, and I will find it. 6 odd months later, we had a meeting, and he said that he had not found anything. In those days, there was a reference book in the College of Pharmaceutics called Chemical Abstracts. I had the keys to the library, and I could go there even on Thursdays. It was a huge library, and I searched every source on electroplating page by page, read them and took notes. I mean, there was actually nothing from 70 years back up to my thesis time, which could have eluded my attention. That kind of bore heavily on my friend, and he apologized a lot. I don't think the 50 students today would study as much as one student did in those days. Extracurricular studies, I mean. In my day, students were addicted to studying. Not just textbooks, different books with regard to their interests, which could be about arts, politics, social studies, novels, etc. But I don't see this nowadays at all. If you would want to look at it with the approach of those days, these are not students. I'm talking about most of them, though, not all of them, because studying has become a secondary activity for them. They are so busy with various things such as mobile phones, internet, chat, Viber, etc. In those days, there were school studies, and on the side, there were a lot of non-curricular studies in addition to sports, politics, etc.
زبانت خوبه گفتم بله و رایتینگت خوبه دکتر گفتم بله بخوا یه متنی بهتون میدم شما بنویسین و بیارین من نوشتم خود کلی هم زحمت کشیدم فرداشو بردم و بعد نگاه کردم تا همین اینقدر بودی خوب بود پس دادم برخورده و دوباره رفتم یه متن بهتر نوشتم باز و بردم و گفت همین یعنی یه همه زحمت کشیدی یعنی آخرش همین یعنی همینا باعث میشد که خب مثلا الان مثلا به بچه‌ها یه چیزی رو دوبار که میگی انجامش بده همه وای دوباره وای استاد نمیشه خودتون انجام بدی
فوتبال فرانسه هم چیزی خیلی چیز نیست. آفساید نبود. ولی هیچ کنم بازی بارسا نمیشه. نه قشنگ نیست.
دو هیچ پیش میفته در مقابل تیم تو.
گل سیبا بود بکنه؟
گل
خیلی عشده داسته شای میلان بود من سه تا پسر دارم اولش که حامد هست متولد 62 شیمیسته علی آقا متولد 65 سه آقا متولد 80
همه شیمیستن؟
علی آقا شیم مواد غذایی خونده از آن موضوعتون که حامد هم که شیم تجزیه خونده کارشناس ارشد بعدم رفت سراغ کار صنعتی و بیزینس و اینا این کار خودم چون منم بهش فاصله بود.
راستش نه تنها ایشون، هر فرد برجسته فرق نمیکنه چه زن باشه چه مرد، وقتی که به طور ویژه میشن این آدم ها و متفاوت از دیگران میشن، این درصد زندگی مشترک از 50-50 یا 40-60 گاهی موقع به مثلا 95-5 یا 10-90 میرسه و بارش میره روی فرد دوم. خب ما مشکلات خاص خودمون رو داشتیم، من خب به هر ویژگی هایی که ایشون داشتن درک میکردم و همراهیشون میکردم. خیلی موقع بود که واقعا 95% اوضاع رو دوش من بود، ولی خب این ویژگی ها وقتی یه آدمی خواسته و داره پیشرفت میکنه، این انصاف نیست آدم جلوی پیشرفت اون آدم رو بگیره. فکر میکنم همه خانم و آقای دیگر هم که همچی فردی تو خانوادهشون داشته باشن همچی کار میکنه. حالا بعضی اسمشو میذارن ایثار، فداکاری، یا مثلا میگن پشت هر مرد موفقی یک زن فداکار وجود داره. حالا ما هم همین داریم میگیم دیگه.
تو ورزش هم من تقریبا 10 رشته ورزشی رفتم، ولی بیشتر احسادم توی والیبال بود، اون ادامه دادم.
یعنی ورود نمی کنم به هیچ مطلبی مگر حرف اول رو بزن.
من برام دوم بودن با آخر بودن هیچ فرق نمی کنم.
این خصلت توی حسین آقا با آقا حامد هم هست، ولی علی آقا ظاهرم به من رفتن خیلی 50-50.
وقت تو حسین شدید تره. تایم بندازی؟ تایم بندازی؟ بگیری تایم، تایم. شوخی میکنی؟ پینگ پونگ من دانشجوی دانشگاه تهران بودم اونجا یاد گرفتم.
I learned ping pong when I was in Tehran University as an undergraduate student before the Islamic Revolution. After that I played it occasionally until I went to Japan. There were the Chinese, the Europeans, the Americans, etc. there. It was a place for exchanging ideas and thoughts. We used to play pool and ping pong.
تبادل افکار و اینا هم بیلیارد بود هم پینگ پونگ اونجا. مهمترین اتفاقی که
The most important thing that happened to me, which was also for the first time, was in September of 2003. People who work in specialized fields and their work has attracted so much interest that others refer to their works and cite them. When the number of citations reaches a certain threshold, they will be considered among the world's top scientists, who, in other words, are referred to as the first 1% in the world.
بهش میگن 1% اول جهان. توش تخصص خودم نفر اول جهان هستم.
In my own field of expertise, I am the first in the world. In the sensors field, I rank first in the world by a significant margin. But the categories they survey are actually categories that pertain to chemistry on the whole. And in chemistry, I rank 300 or something.
آخرین آماری که در 12 نوامبر 2015
In the latest statistics released by Thompson Reuters Corporation on November the 12th, 2015, I was among the top 1% of international students in chemistry, material science and engineering. And in chemistry, I ranked first in the country by a large margin. The second person is Professor Nowruzi. My international publications, as people refer to them, are not actually mine alone. They are a team's, because I never work alone, I work in a team. In terms of books that I have written, I think they number around 10 or 11.
از انتشارات
The first one was an assignment from the American scientific publishers. They invited us to write a chapter for the Encyclopedia of Senses in the World. Anyway, after about 2 years, we managed to finish it, to create it, and it became the biggest chapter in the encyclopedia, with close to, I guess, 3,300 references. Another interesting thing that we noticed was that in the field of sensors, specifically in ion selective electrodes, 7% of the world's contributions have been from our team. When it was written, we checked on it. It was correct, and that had us very excited. You know, the quantity of articles is not important. Citations are important. I mean, the criterion for ranking universities is actually the number of citations. I personally own 11% of the entire citations in Tehran University. Professor Nowruzi owns about 8%, and Dr. Farid Bod has about 3%. In relation to analytical chemistry and electrochemistry, about 3 years ago we ranked first in the whole region. We had two rivals, one of them was Turkey, the other was the usurping Zionist regime, and 3 years ago we overtook them, and we are ahead of them now.
اگه چیزی واقعا بلد نیستن خیلی راحت میگن بلد نیستن باید مطالعه کنن ولی وقتی چیز رو بلدن واقعا بلدن یعنی عمیق و دقیق و یعنی ما که هنوز مثلا یه چیزایی یه دفعه یعنی دانششون تو زمینه علم شیمی واقعا گسترده است
تو همه زمینهای تحقیقاتی میخوان که نام ایران تو رنکینگ اول قرار بگیره یعنی تو همه بحث تو همه بحث‌های تحقیقاتی که مد نظری که تو این انستیتو داره کار میشه بگن که تو ایران داره این کار انجام میشه و این چیزی که براشون خیلی خیلی اهمیت داره
The art of a researcher lies in working hard, gaining experience, becoming a thinker and being able to give ideas. And what will the student do with those ideas? He or she will investigate them, test them, and if the results turn out to be positive, he or she would publish them.
مطالعهشون خیلی زیاده یعنی شاید جزء اساتید باشن که خیلی به روز هستن شما از جدیدترین موضوعهای تحقیقات روز دنیا که وقت صحبت میکنید ببینید قشنگ مسلط هستن مطالعه های جانبی خیلی دارن سوای فیلد کاری خودشون
من خودم مدام مطالعه و
My job is just to study constantly, to investigate and to give ideas, and finally to edit articles already written and give the final opinion and determine which journal it would be fit to send to. It is in this field that I mainly work. Part of my job also deals with technologies, which is also a special field of work separate from my students. But doing practicals in the laboratory? No, no. It has been years that I have put that aside. The sanctions which were imposed on our country didn't affect our work very much. Because as I told you before, we work independently. We do not rely much on foreign countries. The only negative aspect was that some international journals which were supported by the US were told to refuse to publish Iranian articles. That was the only small thing. There were no other specific effects.
دید خیلی وسیعی دارن یعنی ما بعضی وقتا کار تحقیقاتی که انجام میدیم داخل اون در حقیقت پارامترهای تحقیق خودمون هم غرق شدیم ولی ایشون معمولا میان بیرون از بالا به قضیه نگاه میکنن یعنی با یه دید کلی تر بعد وارد جزئیات میشن
سال
In 1991, the university received a letter from the Japanese government saying that they wanted to offer a scholarship in purification technology of chemical products. They told me that if I liked, I could go and participate. I went for the interview and there was a Japanese person there. He interviewed me in English and we said this and that, and finally I accepted. When I arrived in Japan, well, everything was well arranged. They came to pick me up in a nice Mercedes. There was also a placard there with a Japanese lady as the translator. Her name was Mayo Shinozen. She had studied in the US. The other spoke Japanese and she translated. The Japanese were extremely disciplined. It is impossible to imagine or describe it unless you go there and see with your own eyes. In factories, we had, for instance, a technical meeting and we would go for inspection. People in charge of the factory would come and explain. Let's say there was to be a meeting from 10 to 11 o'clock inside the factory, and at 11 o'clock we were assigned to go to the assembly line. Should the time become 11 plus 1 second, they would cut their conversation, no matter who had the speech. It was not like that the manager was talking or anyone else. Everything stopped at 11 o'clock. Very ordered, very kind, and extremely loving towards foreigners. It is so amazing. Since I was very tall and they were very short, wherever someone met me, he or she would say, "Sir, you are so tall." This was the first thing they would say to me, always. When I happened to get on a bus, sometimes there were no seats available and it used to make me laugh. Usually when we get on the bus, the holding bar is too high, so they put hangers on it to suit the shorter people. There, given that they were short, bus roofs weren't that high. And whenever I happened to stand up, I would lower my arm and lean on the bar from above. In the factory where I had my training, they used to make black textiles for Muslim countries. The quality control on those textiles was done by an electron microscope, which most people had only heard of. What I mean is, to what point they were advanced. Factories were often more advanced than universities. For instance, there is a machine called NMA, which is used in chemistry. I remember we had a 500 megahertz version in the factory, while in Osaka University there was only a 400 megahertz version. The one in the factory was more advanced. I have very interesting memories from there. I had practical training in 30 different factories. My view about industry changed completely in terms of discipline and order, and science and technology, it was unbelievable. I would like to become the world's number one in my field, that is chemistry, engineering, and material science. I really like to conquer the first place in the world. Anyway, people who are nominated for the Nobel Prize should usually rank among the top 10 in terms of their publications. It is my ultimate dream to be really able to serve human society so that they could feel it and sense it in their homes.